If you follow mission translation research, chances are that you've used or at least heard about the COMET metric. I'd like to walk you through some of the unexpected aspects of COMET that you might have not been aware of and how to deal with them. To understand COMET, we first need some background of how mission translation systems are evaluated. Traditionally, given a source, the system produces a translation. In the past, we would compare the translation with a high-quality human translation and measure some lexical overlap, which would roughly tell us if the system is doing well or not. However, there are many issues with these simple lexical overlap metrics. That's why researchers have moved on to something else. 4 years ago, a new metric has taken the landscape by storm, having much higher correlations with human judgments. The main trick is that it's not a fixed algorithm based on some heuristics, but a trained model. It is a language model trained to predict the human judgments of a translation quality. This setup also allows us to not always rely on human reference, enabling quality estimation and referenceless metrics. The overall consensus seems to be that handcrafted string matching metrics are obsolete, in favor of these neural metrics. Since then, we've learned a few things about COMET, where it works, where it doesn't, and some other unexpected quirks that we, the practitioners and researchers, should be aware of. We described them in our WMT collaborative paper, Pitfalls and Outlooks in Using COMET, and now we'll briefly look at a few of them. When you read a research paper which claims that they got an average COMET score of something, that could mean almost anything. COMET is actually not a single model, but a whole class of them. That's not an issue in itself, but they produce vastly different ranges of scores. So getting some score with COMET QE20 means something completely different than getting the same score with COMET QV20. In addition, we found that the specific COMET package version can also change the result. For this reason, we created the SacreCOMET package. When you want to make sure that your setup and scores are reproducible, you can specify the evaluation details and the model, and the package will detect all the rest. You can also use it to get the correct BibTeX citation for the specific COMET model that you are using. Next up, we have the COMET itself. Recall that it is trained to emulate the human judgments of translation quality. Here it's important to ask where the training data comes from. Most of it is from the past WMT evaluation campaigns. That is problematic because WMT has been focusing on some languages more than others, so English to German will have on average higher scores than English to Chinese. To show this, we devise an experiment where we take only the bottom 75% of the English to Chinese data sorted by the score. Now when we train COMET on this, COMET will pick up this bias and will think that it is not possible to get high scores in English to Chinese translation. When we compare the baseline COMET, COMET trained on top 75% for Chinese in blue, or COMET trained on bottom 75% for Chinese in red, it changes the average score for a system in that language pair even though the translations remain the same. For now, there is no straightforward solution to this apart from being aware of COMET picking up on this historical bias. The last issue we'll cover is about out of distribution input. COMET is trained on past WMT data, so it mostly saw machine translations of various quality. With the rise of use of LLMs for various NLP tasks, it can happen that the LLM does not produce anything. Following the direct assessment scoring guidelines, this should in most cases receive a score of 0. However, COMET will assign a non-zero value to this empty translation. At the beginning we said that the handcrafted string matching metrics are deprecated, but they provide a good sanity check in this case. Similarly, LLMs can sometimes just provide a translation in a different language than the desired one, which COMET does not seem to bother. In this case, the reference is in German, but the translation is in Czech, and the translation still receives a high score. While string matching metrics are subpar and have a plethora of their own issues, they are a good and fast sanity check. There is much more that we didn't yet touch upon. If you are interested in the pitfalls and outlooks in using COMET, please do read the paper. Thanks for listening.